Hi, I'm David Ghan, Technical Training Consultant with SAS. Today I want to give you a tip on how to work efficiently with database tables in SAS Viya. In SAS 9, you can use database tables just like SAS datasets in SAS code by writing SAS access LIBNAME statements to define libraries to connect to the database. And in SAS Viya, you can use database tables in exactly the same way in your SAS compute session. With SAS Access Libraries, certain elements of your SAS code are automatically converted into native database SQL queries to process the data in database. For example, if you use a SAS WHERE statement in a SAS procedure that reads a database table, the WHERE statement is often converted for you into a native SQL query containing a WHERE clause. This is great because that means the subsetting is done in database and only the subset is returned to SAS. This is an important efficiency consideration when database tables are very large. But in SAS Viya, you can also start a CAS session from your compute session. CAS provides for scalable distributed parallel computing on multiple worker nodes that are remote from your SAS compute session. If you want to use database tables in CAS, what you should do is use a CASLIB to connect to the database directly from CAS. CASLIBs are similar to the idea of SAS libraries, but SAS libraries are for your SAS compute server. CASLIBs are how CAS connects to data directly. When you use CASLIBs to connect to databases, we call that technology SAS data connectors. It's possible to use a SAS library to move data from the SAS compute session into CAS, but if you do it that way for database libraries, the data first moves from the database to your compute server, and then from there it takes another trip up into the CAS session. With a CASLIB, you can create a direct connection between CAS and the database, much more efficient. So that's what I want to show you today. I'm going to demonstrate for you how to best use both SAS Access Libraries and SAS Data Connector CASLIBs in SAS Viya. The database I'll connect to here is a Hive database in Amazon's AWS EMR. That's Amazon's Hadoop as a managed cloud service. But this will serve as a general example for any database you might connect to with SAS, since these methods work the same way for all databases. These option statements here tell SAS where to find some configuration files needed to interact with Hadoop. Then these LIBNAME statements connect to the Hive database. I'm using SAS Viya here, and so these are SAS library definitions, and they'll connect my SAS Viya compute session to Hive. The libraries will be called HiveDef and MyHive. Both libraries connect using the Hadoop Access Engine, and they connect using a Hadoop account called Hadoop. Server equals names the Hive server machine. The first library accesses the tables in the Hive schema called Default. The second library accesses the schema called MyHive. Now I can use the From clause in this proc SQL query to read this Hive table called car S3 in the Hive schema that the Hive def library connects to. The SAS access to Hadoop library engine can convert this SAS SQL into native Hive QL, and then it'll send that Hive native SQL query over to Hive, and it's executed by Hive in database. The data is summarized in Hadoop, and only the summary results are returned to SAS. The results will be stored in an output SAS dataset in the SAS work library. This select statement then queries the SAS dataset so I can see what it contains. So let's execute these statements. And when it's done, the results here show the summary data in the SAS dataset. So back to the code tab. In this data step, the set statement reads a SAS dataset on the SAS compute server. And the data statement will create an output Hive table called PRDSale because of the MyHive libref in the table name. We can even use specialized Hive dataset options like this one, which creates the data for the Hive table as a parquet file. Running this, and the log confirms when it's complete that the Hive table myhive.prdsale was created. Back in the code tab again, this time proc means is going to be used to summarize a Hive table. It's actually the Hive table I just created with the data step. Proc means summarizes the data, and it happens to be one of the few SAS procedures that the SAS Access Engine can convert into an in-database SQL query. So a Hive QL summary query will be generated and sent to Hive. The summary data gets returned to SAS, and SAS generates the proc means report. Executing this, when it's done, the results show the summary report for PROC means. So that's using the LIBNAME engine with the SAS Compute Server. It's a great way to get parts of your SAS code to execute in database. But you might be thinking, okay, but what about using CAS with database tables? Let me go back to the code tab again and show you how that's done. So let me find here, first of all, this CAS statement. I need this CAS statement to start a CAS session. It'll run on a set of nodes remote to the SAS compute session. Then, this CASLIBS statement will define a CASLIB for the Hive database. Think of it as being like a SAS library, but for the CAS session. The CASLIB is called CASEMR. The source type is identified as Hadoop, just like I defined Hadoop as the engine type in the LIBNAME statement I showed you before. And I'm using the server equals, schema equals, and username equals options, just like I did before in the LIBNAME engine, to connect to the Hive server machine, a specific schema, and with the Hadoop user account. These last two options tell CAS where to find the needed Hadoop configuration files. Now that the CASLIB is defined, I can use the CASUtil step to work with the Hive CASLIB. List files creates a report showing the Hive tables and the Hive schema that the CASEMR CASLIB points to. The load statement will load the car S3 table from the CASEMR CASLIB in the Hive system into CAS memory. The data moves directly from the Hive table to the CAS session workers. The list table statement will show all in-memory tables from the EMR CASLIB, and it'll verify that the car S3 table was loaded. So let me highlight this code here, then up to the end of the proc CASUtil and run it. First of all, this file info report, that will show me from the file statement the list of all the available Hive tables that the CASEMR CASLIB connects to. And then if I click on this table information section, this shows me down here that the car S3 table was successfully loaded by that load statement into CAS in memory table. And so now that table is available for processing in memory within Hive. So back in the code tab, this procfit SQL is an example of CAS programming to process the in-memory table. It queries that car S3 table, loaded into CAS memory, in that CASEMR CASLIB. So let's execute this FedSQL step to see the select statement results summarizing the table. And here's the results. So using CASLIBs this way is the best way to access database tables and load them directly into CAS memory. What you don't want to do, particularly with large database tables, is to load them to CAS from a SAS compute server library connected to the database with the LIBNAME method. Now that's a perfectly good way to load SAS datasets that are in local SAS libraries, but not a good practice for database tables. Back in the code, here's an example of what not to do. In this proc CASUtil step, I'm using load data equals and then naming the Hive table via the library reference defined earlier with the LIBNAME statement. That library is defined in the SAS compute session. So what happens here is that the compute session brings the data from the database to the computing node where that compute session is running. And then it's subsequently moved from that location into the CAS memory. So those are my tips and tricks for you today. If you want to follow up on all this and related topics some more, check out the links below. And if you have any questions for me on any of this, send those in the comments here. Also, to view more tips like this, subscribe to the channel.